Humans always had their way of defeating water. We invented boats to reach other continents. We invented dams to convert kinetic energy from water flow to electricity just so we can microwave some frozen pizza. We were always taking a dab against the water. And in this video I'm going to show some incredible human achievements in that area. The USA was always special in that area. They are the ones who divided the entire continent in half just to have cheaper trade deals. Didn't even care about what Panama thinks. They just paid some money to them and built a canal on their territory. And no surprise that the USA has the longest over the water bridge. This bridge is located in the state of Louisiana and its length is over 38 kilometers. It lies on the lake
Pontchartrain
and it's supported by 9,500 pilings. This engineering masterpiece was built in 1956, the southbound, the northbound in 1969. Nice. The bridge was constructed to reduce time it takes to get from North Shore to the New Orleans and back. Now it takes 50 minutes less to get to the other side. But you do need to pay a toll to enter the bridge, $5 or $3 with a toll tag. Overpassing water to reach other lands is an amazing thing on its own, but what about completely getting rid of the water to claim more land? A lot of countries actually do that. The UAE, Qatar and Monaco have all expanded their territory by converting water to land. But the absolute king in this would definitely be the Netherlands. Haha, king, get it, like they have monarchy and stuff. Here is a time lapse of land claims by the Netherlands throughout history. Here's before and after. Today, 17% of the total land area of the Netherlands is land claimed from either sea or lake, and a huge 21% of the population lives below the sea level. There are even places that are negative 5 meters below the sea level. But you might ask, how are they not drowning? They use three things to avoid this: dikes, dunes, and pumps. Dikes and dunes block the water from overflowing, and pumps, well, they pump to drain the water. The Dutch really knows how to handle problems with water. And Soviet Union thought they too can control the water. People of Soviet Union needed more food. More food means more water is needed for agriculture purposes. And they started building artificial reservoirs on Sirdarya and Amudarya rivers, 15 to be exact. And because they built so many reservoirs, Aral Sea started to shrink with a colossal speed. It was shrinking so fast because those two rivers were the only rivers to feed the lake. Now the lake barely gets any water. Aral Sea used to be the fourth largest lake in the world, but now it's tiny compared to the original size. The area is now 9 times smaller than it used to be, and the volume is 21 times smaller. While editing this, I actually noticed something. I looked at the Google Maps and you can actually see the results of this. Like, here's the river Amudarya, and here's all the greenery that it has been done by the Soviet Union, but it was at the cost of a whole lake. Like, all of the river flow was used for agriculture purposes. Look how many freaking fields there are. So, that's how people show the water who's the boss. Watch my previous videos to not miss out on the easy to understand facts. Bye bye!